Miss Margaret Cavendish, reading the epilogue from her new book, The Blazing World, printed by A. Maxwell, 1668.
By this poetical description, you may perceive that my ambition is not only to be empress, but authoress of a whole world, and that the worlds I have made, both the blazing and the other philosophical world mentioned in the first part of this description, are framed and composed of the most pure, that is, the rational parts of matter, which are the parts of my mind, and whose creation was more easily and suddenly effected than the conquest of the two most famous monarchs of the world, Alexander and Caesar. Neither have I made such disturbances as they, or caused so many dissolutions of particulars, otherwise named deaths, as they did. For I have destroyed but some few men in a little boat, which died through the extremity of cold, and that by the hand of justice, which was necessitated to punish their crime of stealing away a young and beauteous lady. And in the formation of those worlds, I take more delight and glory than ever Alexander or Caesar did in conquering this terrestrial world. And though I have made my blazing world a peaceable world, allowing it but one religion, one language, and one government, yet could I make another world as full of factions, divisions, and wars as this is of peace and tranquility. And the rational figures of my mind might express as much courage to fight as Hector and Achilles had, and be as wise as Nestor, as eloquent as Ulysses, and be as beautiful as Helen. But I, esteeming peace before war, wit before policy, honesty before beauty, instead of the figures of Alexander, Caesar, Hector, Achilles, Nestor, Ulysses, Helen, etc., etc., chose rather the figure of honest Margaret Newcastle, which now I would not change for all this terrestrial world. And if any should like the world I have made and be willing to be my subjects, they may imagine themselves as such, and they are such. I mean in their minds, fancies, or imaginations. But if they cannot endure to be subjects, they may create worlds of their own and govern themselves as they please. But yet let them have a care not to prove unjust usurpers and to rob me of mine. For concerning the philosophical world, I am empress of it myself. And as for the blazing world, it having an empress already, who rules it with great wisdom and conduct, and which empress is my now dear platonic friend, I shall never prove so unjust, treacherous, and unworthy to her as to disturb her government, much less to depose her from her imperial throne for the sake of any other, but rather choose to create another world for another friend entirely.
Miss Margaret Cavendish.